Well done, sir. And with that, I believe we are ready to proceed.
Let us be about our business, then. The next patrol may not be so credulous.
Why must you be so disappointingly brusque? You're not at all as Minfilia described, you know. I don't think you've favored me with so much as a single compliment since we set out. Tell me, did your time in the wilderness sap you of all your charm, or are you holding it in reserve for your beloved?
This is neither the time nor the place.
Well, call me old-fashioned, but when I'm risking life and limb infiltrating an Imperial castrum, I like to be sure of my comrades' motivations.
I see now where Alfino gets it from. Minfilia is dear to me, it is true, but not in the way you think. 15 years passed, when she was still but a child. There was an incident at a parade. A gubu broke free of its fetters and ran amok through the streets of Uldar. Had I been more attentive, I could have prevented it. But I was distracted, and her father was killed. I feared she would never recover. But in the years that followed, she showed herself to be more resilient than I had ever imagined. And when she learned of her gift, she did not flinch from the responsibility, but sought to guide others on the path. She touched the hearts of all around her. Mine, Louissoir, every science. In those dark days following the calamity, she was our guiding light, our hope for a brighter future. She had so many dreams, and I would give anything to make them come true.
My apologies. I can see she means the world to you. I did not mean to pick at old scars.
No harm done, I assure you. But fair is fair, my lady. What is Minfilia to you?
You mean you don't know? Only my dearest friend. When I finally emerged from my torpor, I learned that nary a day had passed without her asking after me. She never gave up hope. And neither will I.
Then for Minfilia's sake, let us pray that these vestiges of Hydaelyn's intervention will lead us to her.